It's time to lift your spirit, and Jill Berlin is here to motivate and inspire you.
Here's to whatever puts a smile on your face, whatever makes you happy, people.
Welcome to the Jill Berlin Show on Triad Today.
And welcome back. You are listening to the Jill Berlin Show on WSJS. All right, we've got Felicia. Come on in. Come and sit down right here. All right, we're going to pull her in. We are so excited. By the way, I already have one person asking about your book, Rise and Reinvent. And I'm going to bring it up over here. All right. And the other thing is scoot in a little closer.
Got to get super close.
Yeah, there you go.
There we go.
And then here, go ahead and put those on. All right, Rise and Reinvent. Here's the deal. This book is amazing. I've already started to thumb through it, look through it. And I'm just going to give you an example of what you can find in here. Okay. Habits. Successful people make it a habit to watch, read, or listen to something positive each day. Make it your goal to start your day with something inspiring. You'll be amazed at how it sets the tone for peace and focus throughout the day. Incorporating a morning routine of prayer and mindful meditation will further center and ground you as you navigate your day. I love this. And then the best part is there's a space right beside each page to write and just journal your thoughts. So as a writer, this really resonated with me. I cannot speak more highly of this book. Tell us a little bit about how you came up with this idea.
Well, you know, it's interesting. Like many of
you
the
are
listeners.
So gorgeous.
Oh my God, you are too.
I was
too.
Just staring at you.
You are too. So right back at
sorry,
you.
Sorry,
right?
I'm sorry to just completely throw you off right there.
Oh gosh, no. Like many of us, you know, we are so, so busy with kids, with working, with everything that's going on in life. So my goal in writing this book was trying to figure out a way to move out of that whole 98%, that study. So 98% of us are just mediocrity, average, moseying through life. How do we move into a place of extraordinary living? How do we move into being extraordinary? So not like when we were younger without kids and we can go, oh, I'm going to cuddle up and read a whole book. I thought, how can we get just quick reflections that actually change our thinking, really quick snippets that we can read to help us just do simple things to move from being mediocre to an extraordinary space.
And it's so true because our world is just, it's a bullet point world, mm-hmm. right?
It is.
And people don't have time mm-hmm. and they don't have time to reflect. And so I think it is genius mm-hmm. that you made these little snippets and then right mm-hmm. beside a short little area. It's not mm-hmm. like multiple pages where you have to journal right. for days, mm-hmm. right? It's just right. short. You can even write bullet points yourself
right.
and just really start to reflect. And so, you know, first of all, you did not sign this.
Okay.
So I'm going to hold you accountable. And so I want it to be signed. Second, what is it that you would tell folks who it is one thing to read and write and jog down some thoughts. It is another to put it into action. Mm-hmm. What do you tell people? How, you know, Dr. Maya Angelou said that the most important characteristic you need to have is courage. Mm-hmm. Where do you muster up the courage?
I think that as it relates to Rise and Reinvent, as well as courage, I always say, well, when you're reading this book, we'll talk about this book. So think about three things, and we can put that in your life. Three things that you are ready to make a commitment for. So one, I say as the reader, if you are reading this, one, commit to and write that date down that you're making that commitment to change this way you think, to for the courage for everything. This is the day I commit to moving from mediocrity and just mundane living. This is the day. Two, you're going to say, okay, I am ready to change my mindset. But then that comes with putting in the work. And, you know, it's work to change our thinking. And then lastly, three, we're going to say, okay, what is within my grasp? What can I do right now as I've made this commitment? I've changed my mindset. What's low-hanging fruit where I can now grasp to become extraordinary? Ah, so that's what I would do.
I love that. I love that.
Thank you.
And you know, so I'm walking this journey with my friend who has stage four cancer, and I've been really purposeful about making sure I live out the purpose that God has for me instead of being like, oh God, please let this happen or that happen. Yeah. And the fact that this just fell into my hands right now is I really do feel like it's a God thing. Mm-hmm. And I know that this book is going to help people rise up and reinvent themselves.
Thank you.
And I love what you have put in here. My question to you is, where did you get the inspiration? Who was it? What mentors along the way that really influenced you?
Actually,
just imagine the impact you're having on, you know, all the younger generations, men and women. I mean, boys and girls.
Oh gosh, Jill, it's exciting. It's inspiring because, you know, I also am the founder of the Master's League Foundation for Boys.
Yep.
And as I wrote this book, the inspiration just came from around me and wanting to make a difference in our community, in our space, in the life of young people, in the life of people that are transitioning from a new role in their job, in the life of a mother that's just at home, a stay at home thinking, oh, this job's not important, what I'm doing right now. So this book was inspired to touch everyone. You know, the college student that's moving, as I wrote it, you know, I got inspiration from my husband, from my children, mainly from what I saw around me. And I utilize it for myself too, thinking, how can I become, you know, extraordinary in every area? How can I change my thinking to help someone else? And as I noticed, it was just simple things that we need to do that we're already doing, but how do we step it up a notch?
And it's so important. What I love about this book is it really does reshift and reset your way of thinking. And so, like you said, if you start each day with this in a positive way, after time after time after time, it cannot do anything else but make a positive impact, because we are what we think about ourselves. I tell my kids all the time that there's going to be a ton of people in life who put you down. Don't be first in line in your head, putting yourself down. And I think that's what this does, is it allows you to just self-reflect and then also build yourself back up. What is it that you think that, or what are you hearing from other people who are starting to use this rise and reinvent? I mean, I cannot talk about this book enough. Judge Cubbage was just in here and she was like, I want that. I want that book. Yeah. And I was like, well, the author, she's coming. And so anyway, what do you think, or what are you hearing from other people?
You know, it's exciting because I got a
call
yesterday.
Aside from me, who's like your number one fan.
You know, it's interesting. I got a call yesterday and I'm starting to get to do Bible studies and ladies groups where we're going to focus on these practical skills in the book. And, you know, I'm excited because it's resonating with people. And that was the desire, that it would resonate. And it's resonating with all ages, where parents are saying, hey, I'm going to get a copy for my daughter to take that to school. So it's nice that it's resonating. It's nice that our Christian community is using it with their ladies' leadership groups and their prayer groups. And, you know, it's so exciting how many areas it's going to be used in. So, you know, I have, can I talk about my book signing
that's Please.
Coming up?
That's actually what I was going to ask you next. So thank you for reading my mind. Yeah, tell me about your event.
So we have our Rise and Reinvent book signing that comes, it's this Saturday from 4 to 6 at Springhouse Restaurant, which is a really cool little restaurant with a library there. So come on out. It's free. I would love to meet everyone in the community, to talk about the book, to just really share our thoughts on the book, to just learn more about you. And then we also have the Rise and Reinvent Community Book Club that's on Facebook. So we have a whole community that's dedicated to Rise and Reinvent, where as you read, we're going to set some dates and times to come in there and we talk as a group. And then we've got some upcoming fireside chats that will be taking place in December.
I absolutely love that. And I think that's so important to make sure that you come together and encourage one another to talk about how you are rising and reinventing yourself, because we all need that encouragement. We really do. Okay, let's talk a little bit. How much time do we have, Christian? All right, let's talk a little bit too about the, with the book signing, you were talking about Springhouse Restaurant. Springhouse Restaurant, Winston-Salem, 4 to 6 p.m. Rise and Reinvent book signing. I'm going to say it again. Springhouse Restaurant this Saturday, 4 to 6 p.m. You got to go. You got to meet this gorgeous lady. Beautiful inside and out. Rise and Reinvent. If you can't make the book signing, go get the book.
Yes, Amazon.
We all need one. We all need a copy.
Yeah.
All right, stay tuned. You're listening to the Jill Berlin Show on WSJS.